kani kadai ka Batik CCTV bat pidang pet ya ka kubur bamankasni belawan rasa pi tak ko umrupa ringkat bat ko orange Nissan lom sokpo near Fabricate Shillong.
Nissan Kicks bookings open now.
Ketenat Sports and Youth Affairs jong ka sorkar jela kala baha pisa saup kandai laktam syaki laipun retuli ki Sports Association kibaran ha ka jela nakabenta ka samoy jong usnam arajar kat pra hadu arajar kat kandai. Bat nakabenta usnam arajar kat kandai hadu arajar arpopat lamang pisa laipusau laktam syaki hinri pusau tuli ki Sports Association. Ya kini lapan tip do menteri sorkar bakmi ya ketenat Sports and Youth Affairs jong ka sorkar jela ubak bantai dorling do. Habat jubab ya kejingkeli belawan ra da MLA ke seng kongres na mau senram uba hima M. Shangpliang ha ka dorbar senrai jong ka yeng dorbar thawain ke jela ka balalong ha ka kat artrik mentau nailur arjar kat kendai.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir. Well, sir, the statement is also available to me wherein the total amount for the assistance that has been given during the year 2018-19 is 49,05,000. But sir, very recently we had a review meeting from the Public Accounts Committee, and the figures that are made available to the PAC by the Sports Department is different from what is seen today. I do not know how these amounts have been compiled. I would like the Honourable Minister to reply as to why there is a disparity or there is a difference in both these statements. I have a statement from the PAC and I have a statement placed on the table of the House.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir. Thank you to the Honourable Minister, Honourable Member of the from Mau Senram. I've given you have the other statement with him, but as per the report from my department, maybe sir, I have tabled in the place in the table of the House, but regarding that miss, I think. The mismatch with what he have with him.
Discrepancy.
So, yeah, maybe I'll find out and let him know to honourable members.
That's all right, sir. That can be furnished to us and rectified accordingly, because it gives a very wrong impression with two different figures coming out for the same purpose. Sir, may I know from the honourable minister of sports, how much money has been spent during the year 2018-19 for construction of stadiums?
Sir, Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, that is a different question, Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, and I require notice.
Sir, this is not a different question. I'm coming to the main related question. Why, sir, is because I will give the answer to the Honourable Minister if he does not have the answer. The answer is, during 18-19, sir, the Sports Department has spent 10,83,36,000 rupees. 10,83,36,000 rupees for construction of stadiums. Whereas, sir, the department has spent only 43 lakhs rupees. Only 43 lakhs rupees the department has spent to provide financial assistance to our sports associations in the state, in the district and in subdivision level. Why this disparity and why this difference and why so much stress has been given or importance or inclination given for construction of stadiums to the tune of 10,83,00,000?
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, regarding with this question, sir, I'll look into it, sir.
Sir, if I may say that you give nuts you get monkeys. This is exactly that is happening, sir. I would not like to make a speech here, but the statement itself, which is on the table of the House and for perusal of all the members who are responsible MLAs of their own areas, so we can see that for a taekwondo, which has so much potential to bring medals for our state, the department has provided for the 5th Grand Open Taekwondo Championship only 15,000, sir. And I'll also say some more, that for the Northeast Zone Interstate Badminton Championship, the Meghalaya State Badminton Association was provided only 60,000, sir, 60. So there are many more. I do not want to embarrass the department, which is really like giving nuts to monkeys, sir. I don't know why this attitude towards the sportspersons.
Sir, just to clarify one or two points, with your permission. Sir, I don't know the numbers that Honourable Member is talking about from the PAC, because those numbers are not available to us, so I think it will be not possible for us to really comment on what those numbers are. But the numbers that we have given in our reply are the numbers that are correct, sir. That's number one. So number two, I think what the Honourable Member is mentioning about the fact that if peanuts are given to monkeys, then that's what happens. And so that is actually the issue that we are all trying to address. Because from 2015-16, if you look at the numbers, 2015-16, an amount of only 29 lakhs was sanctioned. In the year 2016-17, only 29 lakhs was sanctioned. In the year 2017-18, nothing was sanctioned. And then came 2018-19, where we tried to increase it to 49 lakhs. And this year again, we're trying to increase it. And next, in the years to come, we could increase it. So therefore, sir, this has been the trend for a long time. So as I said, if you see the past records, 29 lakhs, 29 lakhs, 2017-18, zero. Zero was there in 2017-18. So therefore, it's a concern. And I think we have met the organizing, the different associations that are there. And we are trying to work out on how we can financially support them. But as I mentioned, to bring it to the notice of the House and everybody, that this is the kind of trend for the past 5-6 years we have seen. And we are in the process of improving those.
Yeah. Sir, may I know from the Honourable Minister, that is it a fact that the state athletes are being paid ₹3.95 per day?
Minister, please. Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, that actually is not related with this question, so I require notice for that.
Sir, this is not acceptable to me, sir. All these are related to the financial assistance given to the association, sir. Sir, there is a press clipping from where I'm quoting, sir. The press clipping says, state athletes get ₹3.95 per day. I'm sure the minister is aware about this, and can I get a categorical answer to this?
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, right now I don't have with me in regarding this question, so I require notice.
So I have another question. So the Meghalaya State Olympic Association had selected 15 athletes from Meghalaya to participate in the coming national games in the state, which have prospects of winning medals. Now, sir, these athletes have been deputed for intense training outside the state. The MSOA had already applied for funds from the department. May I know from the Honourable Minister whether that money has been sanctioned or not?
Yes, sir, it's being on the process to sanction, sir.
May I know how much is the amount likely to be sanctioned?
It's being processed. I don't know the figure of that.
What is the projected amount by the MSOA?
Sir, I'll just like to intervene here, sir. So the department, sir, the associations have given us a projection for team preparation, which amounting to almost 41 crores. But of course, these are for the next 3 years, and the department is examining it. It is a huge figure, but of course we realize the importance of this. And for 18 disciplines, they have given it. It's 18 crores for 2019-20, 11 crores for 2020, and 11 crores for 2021, total of 41 crores. But we're examining the matter, and we'll see how to move forward.
It is your sir, I understand, sir, what the Honourable Chief Minister is trying to answer. Yes, it is a fact that there is a huge projection for the entire preparation of the sportspersons of the state. My question is very, very specific. I mentioned that there were 15 athletes for the athletics events, not for the whole state. So for these 15 athletes, they need to go for training immediately. They're waiting to go, and the Meghalaya Olympic Association has not been sanctioned with the money. I want to know, when is the money being sanctioned, and how much is the amount that the MSOA has asked for?
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, I've already answered that question. And the matter, I already answered, sir, it's being examined. And how much, right now, I don't have a figure with me, sir, but I'll provide that to the honourable member.
No, sir, I'm yet to finish, sir.
You have exceeded five.
Sir, this was my fourth one, sir. I had made my counts because I have already written the questions before I came, sir. Sir, this year, many sportspersons have missed out opportunities to take part in the national and the zonal championships due to the non-release of funds by the government. So, we need our sportspersons to go and participate in different zonal championship or national championship to prepare themselves and to prepare themselves for the upcoming national games. Now, every time that these state associations go to the department for help, all these proposals are being delayed, either not sanctioned or just kept in abeyance. Sir, the East Zone Junior Athletic Championship is going on now from the 10th to the 13th of September in Ranchi. We miss our sportsperson have missed, sir, to go to this championship. Why? Because the department was sitting over the requirement funds. Again, sir, on the 10th of October now coming, 10th of October 2019, the 59th National Open Athletics Championship is being held in Bengaluru. Are we going to miss this again? May I ask the Honourable Minister, please?
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, actually, I once again like to thank the Honourable Member from Mau Sundram. He's so concerned about the sports because he also, once upon a time, he was a director of sports department. So thanks again to him, sir. But I'll tell you, sir, in the floor of the house, I'm the sport person. I love sports from the bottom of my heart, sir.
So we want a direct answer.
No, I'll answer, sir, but why I'm saying this, sir? When we took over, sir, the government, 1.5 year now, I'm trying to streamline the department, sir. The sports department is a very, very important department, sir, in our state. Every 60 MLA, they come to me and asking help. Infrastructure or any, you know, kind of participate in different sports.
But we are not getting anything.
No. Yet will come. but the fact here, sir, it's not easy for my department to streamline overnight of my department, and I urge upon all the 60 MLAs, including Honourable Member from Mau Sundram, to come and meet me from time to time, suggest, help me. for streamline this department. Everyone, we are talking about the sports. Sports is a basic, is a very important department.
Sir.
But let me finish, sir.
Sir, I want an answer to whether our National Open Athletics Championship team are going or not. One answer, please. One line.
I am asking him to reply directly.
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir. I'll do my best. They will be going to participate in Ranchi and along with the coaches of the department.
Not Ranchi, sir. Bengaluru. Ranchi is over. You missed the bus for Ranchi, sir.
Let me answer. Sir, for Bengaluru or any competition outside the state will be participate, sir.
So, it is okay, please.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, clarification to the Honourable Member's concerns. So the team has gone to Ranchi, sir. That is number one. He's saying that we missed the bus, which is not a correct information. I just wanted to clarify that, sir.
Honourable Minister does not know that the team has gone to Ranchi.
They have gone. You said no. I said they have gone.
Now you're saying they have gone. Thanks to the CM, at least he knows that the team has reached Ranchi.
I am gone, I told you.
But the minister...
So sorry.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, reply to start question number 75A. Yes, sir. Minister replying, during 2018-19, an amount of 49,05,000 was sanctioned to various sport association. May I know from Honourable Minister the plan outlay of 2018-19, which was earmarked for the Department of Sports and Youth Affairs?
Plan outlay, he wants to know how much money has been earmarked
for the 2018-19.
Yeah.
Sir, I have already replied that and given in the house for this 49,05,000 for the 2018-19.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, for the information, the house sport department in 2019 up 2022, it is very important and crucial department. So regarding with this matter, it seems that the Chief Minister or Deputy Chief Minister, they have to assist and to look after, because especially the National Game will be held in the year 2022. Sir, it seems that the Minister, he don't know even the plan outlay. I have with me, sir, outlay, which you have already mentioned, they have already said laid on the table, the house. He lay here only the very sport activity, only this, the name of association, and also the amount earmarked, not the plan outlay, sir.
The question is...
Yes, sir. That's why, sir, my question, I'm going to say to my question. My question here now, sir. See, once you are given money, that will be earmarked for the plan outlay. My question now, how much department have been earmarked for the plan outlay 2018-19? Minister said have only been table. It's not table here. Plan outlay is different, because from that amount, from that outlay, you earmark various activities. That is my question, sir, again.
So may I just intervene, sir, here? So the, of course, the question was very specific to the sports association. So obviously, sir, the answer for outlay will not be there, sir. That's number one. And obviously, number two, sir, the honorable member is asking a separate question. It's regarding the entire budget. So if the question was specific to the budget of the entire sports department, we could have put that. But having said that, sir, let me just inform the house. The numbers for 19-20 are with me, but of course 18-19 are not there with me right now. But we have a budget outlay of 200 plus crores, about 201 crores for budget outlay for sports for 2019-20.
Sir, so regarding with this matter, I understand that many important. Once you held any association, it should be for the plan outlay. Chimurasev already mentioned that the plan of the approval in 1819 is 201. While 2019-20, there's no outlay, and no outlay in the budget of the department here. That 200 that have only been laid, that is only for the national game. So second question, sir, to honourable minister. From the, again, sir, because we have to spend the money from what we have on the earmark. If the earmark money, the sport, from where money will get? So my question, sir, only last. My question regarding this sir. May I know from Honourable Minister, what is the expenditure from that planned outlay which have been earmarked in 2018-19 from 201, sir?
Deputy Speaker, sir, actually I don't have that figure with me. I require notice.
It is only my request to Honourable Minister, when he came to the House, especially with the budget provision and expenditure, better he come prepare and also know about the plan of this so that he will not be embarrassed, especially him also the House and the whole, sir.